There's a bunch of changes in Kdenlive for the next release that is going to happen later this year in November. One particular thing I really like are named workspaces already available in daily builds. I'm assuming you very well know that Kdenlive comes with a whole bunch of docs. Some of them you need most of the time, like the project monitor or the timeline. Others are only applicable at certain stages of production. So what the team did is identifying which is which, and then creating default named workspaces for those common stages of production. They are available in the upper right corner of the main window as well as in the view menu. The first one is called Logging. This is where you review all the footage you dropped into the project bin to rate and set in and out points for further insertion into the timeline. So there's project bin, clip monitor for reviewing, audio mixer for some reason, clip properties, and project notes. You don't usually need a lot more than that when deciding which clips are goners and which ones are keepers. The second one is called Editing. Even though technically it's the second stage of working on a project, it actually shows up by default when you start Kdenlive. I'm assuming this is to cause less surprise for new users because it just uses a very familiar layout for a non-linear video editor. Anyway, this is where you can view clips from the project bin, maybe tweak in and out points one last time and then drop those clips onto the timeline, then review the sequence. The third workspace is Audio. This is where you pay close attention to how you mix dialogues or voiceovers and background music. You still have the timeline to navigate your sequence, but you also get to see more of the audio mixer and you see the audio spectrum dock. The fourth dock is Effects. Again, you get to see the timeline, the viewer graph docs is set to project monitor by default, and you see both the list of effects and the dock where you change settings of the effects and animate them. Finally, the core workspace is where you see both effects and their settings and core res tools like RGB parade, vectorscope and histogram. This is intended for final core grading before you render your video. Now, can you make your own layouts and save them? The answer is yes, you can do that. Tweak your layout, then go to view save layout and give it a name. You can even remove the default layouts or change the order of their appearance. For that, go to view manage layouts. So you get here the remove button, two arrow shape buttons to change the order of layouts, and then the reset button that restores factory defaults in case you messed up badly. You can test all that right now. Just go to Kdenlive's website, visit the download section, scroll down to daily builds and download either app image for Linux or the build for Windows. Now, I'm not suggesting that you move your production to daily builds. These are, after all, potentially quite unstable and probably eat babies. But if you're watching this, you probably really want to know what kind of stuff is cooking up for the next major release of Kdenlive. And this is one of those things. Thank you for watching and see you soon.